Hello, you beautiful lads, and welcome back to the channel. Hopefully, you lads are doing fantastically well. Hopefully, you lads are happy and safe. One more day in Chelsea Football Club's history, and we have got lots to talk about today. Some very great transfer news coming in from some sources, and a lot of contract news too. Without any further ado, let's begin with the video. First off, let's talk about some great transfer news. Football.London have reported that Chelsea are interested in signing the one and only David Alaba. Yes, guys, the same David Alaba who plays for Bayern Munich and who is out of contract next summer, which means we might be able to sign him for free. Yes, guys, on a free transfer, just like Thiago Silva, we have to give a lot of money to his agent, around 10 or 12 million euros. But money is never a problem at Chelsea Football Club. And if we manage to sign him, it will be an amazing signing. Trust me, I have watched him a lot with Bayern. You might have too, because he played a crucial role last year in winning the Champions League with Bayern Munich. And he was superb. He can play as a left back, as a center back, and he's a team leader. Apart from that, he's only 28 years old, and next year, he will only be 29 years old. So he still has 3, 4, 5 years left in his locker, and that is amazing. He's not too old. He has got experience, and Thiago Silva, remember, his contract expires next summer. So if he manages to sign Alaba, it would be the perfect replacement for someone like Thiago Silva. That is just my opinion. What do you think about David Alaba's signing? Not too costly at all. Barcelona are also interested in him, and a lot of other clubs are too. United are interested in him. Liverpool want to sign him, but hopefully Chelsea sign him at any cost. I don't think there is a lot of chance we sign him because he wants to go to Barcelona, but Barcelona are almost bankrupt, so it does not make any sense. But if they manage to offload Messi, it will take a lot of money out of their wage budget and they could sign him. So hopes up, hopefully David Alaba comes to Chelsea. Speaking about Bayern Munich defenders, Christian Falk has reported that Jerome Boateng will not renew his contract with Bayern Munich next year, and he wants to come to Chelsea. Chelsea are also keeping an eye on the situation, and we might sign him. To me, Jerome Boateng does not seem a sensible choice because he's older than Alaba. He is also on a free transfer next year, but we have already got Thiago Silva, and Thiago Silva is doing an amazing job till now. And if he continues his form throughout the year, if he does not get injured a lot, we might easily extend his contract to 2 or 3 years more. So what are your thoughts about this transfer? Jerome Boateng for me is a big no, but David Alaba any day of the week. He's welcome to join Chelsea. He's so, so good, and he's quite younger compared to Jerome Boateng. I guess all the talk today is about center backs. Don't worry, there is still a lot to come, but now let's focus on Thiago Silva. Silva is on international duty with Brazil, and he has given a lot of press interviews. In a press interview, he said that he would like to renew his contract at Chelsea for a minimum of 2 or 3 years. As I was saying before, Thiago Silva himself wants to renew his contract, and if he performs well this season, as he has so far, and if we win a trophy this season with him, there is absolutely no chance we should let him go. We should renew his contract, give him whatever he wants, because he has changed our defense a lot. Previously, we used to play with Rudiger, Christensen. Both of them were so, so pathetic at the back. Both of them would either put a masterclass or a disaster class, but Thiago Silva is very consistent, has a lot of experience, and Kurt Zouma will learn a lot from him. So it is a no-brainer. Thiago Silva, if he wants a new contract, if he performs well this season, give it to him, put it on the table, and let him sign it. Now, let's talk about a left winger, Christian Pulisic. No more of the center back talk. Pulisic has been injured for a long time now. He was injured while training before the Burnley game. Then Werner came on instead of him and Pulisic has still not recovered. He went to the US camp to see his friends, to see his American teammates. Don't worry, he did not fly all the way to America. The camp was in Wales and he just went there by a car or something. I don't know, but he has come back and Lampard has called him back. He's no more at the camp. He was not training there. He was not playing football. He has come back. He is continuing his recovery here. And as far as I know, there is nothing more of an aggravation to the previous injury. There is nothing more to talk about. It has not severed. Everything is normal. The recovery is in process and nothing is to be worried about. And if all goes well, he should be back after the international break. Hopefully, that is what I hope. But if he's back, what would you prefer? Werner on the left wing, Tammy Abraham as a striker? Or should he be back on the left wing and Werner as the striker? To me, Tammy Abraham has done a wonderful job, don't get me wrong, but Pulisic, if 100% fit, should start every game for Chelsea because he is a very dangerous guy when he is 100% fit. And we saw that last year. He arrives in the box again and again. And while Ziyech crosses, I think Ziyech and Pulisic will combine for a lot of goals if Pulisic manages to stay fit, and hopefully he does, because if Pulisic stays fit, trust me, we are going to win the Premier League, that is for sure. Now, let's talk about the transfer budget in the January transfer window. We thought that we would not get any money whatsoever for Frank Lampard because we have already spent 200 million euros this summer, but things look very, very positive, and it has been reported that Lampard will receive around 80-85 million euros to conduct his transfers in the January transfer window. You know what that means. That means one thing only, that is we might sign Declan Rice. Yes, guys, West Ham are asking for 70-80 million, but if Marina Granovskaya shows her magic again, then that 70 million could be down to 50 or who knows, even 40 million. That would be amazing for us. And 80 million of transfer money is a lot of money in a January transfer window. And I don't think we will make a lot of signings. We will sell a lot of players. Hopefully, Emerson to Inter, Olivier Giroud is rumored to be going out, and a lot of other players. But I don't think we will sign a lot. Maybe one or max two players, that would be it. By January, our team would be thriving. Our team would have gelled together perfectly. And you would see the best threat from any side in the Premier League. Attacking-wise and defensive-wise. That was it for now, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all the support. Write down in the comments below whatever you thought about this video. Whatever you thought about the news. What do you think about the transfers? And don't forget to like the video, would be amazing. Thank you so much for all the support. Until next time, stay safe, stay home, stay wherever you are, and cheers.